Hey everyone, it's Megan with Alder and Nance, and I'd like to apologize for being missing in action the last couple of months. That does not mean that I have not been doing some things behind the scenes. I have been going thrifting, and that includes this box right here of patterns that I picked up at my local antique store, big garage sale, where I ran into my lady that I bought some of my patterns from in the past. She actually gave me this entire box of patterns for $5. I still can't get over that. Now, this pattern on top is not one from that sale. I found this inside of the antique store. It was a couple of weeks later that I found this one. I actually did go ahead and pick up for James. So that is that one. First, let's go ahead and roll my intro. The first one I have is this Advanced 8978 little pattern for a shirt and shorts. I think it's a beach set is what it says. Men's cabana set. So this was the one that I picked up at my local antique store. I picked it up for like $2, I think it was. Like I was saying, this entire box was just $5. I still can't get over the fact that she sold this to me for $5 for all of these. So let's go ahead. And some of these are very crispy. It's not bad. So my first one I'm pulling out is McCall's 6638. I don't know what year this is from. I will put any of the years down below where you can actually go in and see what year these patterns are from. I also have Simplicity 5885, which I believe this one has been reprinted. I'm not 100% sure, but I do think that this one has been reprinted. Then I have Simplicity 2456, which is this blouse pattern set. And this is a bust 36, so I'm actually kind of happy with the sizing on these. It's not going to be too hard for me to actually grade these up whenever it comes time for me to grade them up. And then I have Simplicity 2062, which is another blouse pattern set. And hold on. I think I have a visitor. Yes, I have a visitor. Hello. Okay, yes, I do have a visitor, so hopefully I don't have to cut a lot out of here. Then I have McCall's 4369. You want to say hello? So this is my new baby. This is my new baby. She is just a couple of months old, and this is Little Miss Hugs. And no, you cannot eat the patterns. No, ma'am, do not eat my patterns. And then I have Simplicity 3034, which is this dress set, which is absolutely adorable. It is a bust 36, so another one that I should be able to grade up real easily. But it does look like this one had been opened. Ah, there she goes. Then we have Vogue pattern 4304. Which looks like a 60s style pattern. And this one does not look like it's been used at all unless they were really, really good at putting them back in the envelope. Then we have Miss Crispison here, which is Simplicity 3079. And unless someone's used, yeah, someone has used this one. So I will actually look at all of these later on and see if they have been used and if I'm missing pieces to them. I am not a pattern reseller. If you would like to find some of these patterns, you might be able to find them over on Stephanie Canada's website, Backroom Finds. I know she's got a lot of patterns on her website. Then we have Simplicity 5669, which includes the skirt, top, and the cape, which is really cute. And that is best 36. And then we have McCall's 7439 with a best 36. Oh, this would have fit me about 10 years ago. And then we have So Easy and Advanced Pattern 3150. It is a juniors and misses, and I don't know what size this is, but it is fairly pretty. So size 16. So it is a misses size. So I'll go ahead and pull this one up out of the side. We have men's, and I can't read it. I think it's 3300. Which is really cute, but it is used and very fluffy. And then I have some McCall's children's patterns. This one is 743. This is absolutely adorable. I don't have any babies, but I do like collecting patterns, and it doesn't matter if it is children's or if it's women's or sizes that I don't fit. Then I have Vogue pattern number 2059. It is a children's pattern. Then we have Simplicity 4884, which is a Jiffy suit, which is really cute. Maybe. You know what? A lot of the old money styles and quiet luxury styles are coming back into style, I've noticed here lately. So this would be really cute to make. It is a best 36, so I could grade that up. Then we have Simplicity 5366, which, oh, this is so cute. I absolutely love this right here. And then we have a Vogue pattern 8216. Which, another couple of dresses I wouldn't mind making. It is a size 10 with a best 32, though. So this one, I would have a hard time probably grading it up. But I could look at the pattern pieces and actually pattern this out myself. I have another Vogue pattern, 6951. Which, both of these are adorable. So it comes with the skirt, pants, and the top. And this is a bust 34. So that would be 10 inches to grade up on me. So, it's doable, but I would rather just take a look at the lines and pattern it out for myself. Then we have Butterick 4811, which is a bust, it's a 14 through 18. And I'm not going to try and find sizing really easily on here, but it is a 14 through 18. I have a Very Easy, Very Vogue 8565. Yes, ma'am. Where are you? I hear you. Where'd you go? Okay, we have another Very Easy, Very Vogue 14 through 18, and this was also a 12 through 16, which reminds me a lot of my childhood and the clothes that I would see my teachers wearing. So this pattern is from 1986, so the year I was born. And then I've never heard of this, and I don't want to butcher the name of this pattern company. But this blazer set is so cute. It is so cute. And it's pattern number 203. I've never heard of this company. I'm going to have to do a little bit of research on them. And I don't know what sizes come in it, but it doesn't look like it's ever been used to me. But that is so cute. And then we have Simplicity's 7467. It's a large 16 through 18. So, body. Eh. 16 through 18, so it goes from a 34 to 40 inch bust for this one, which that's the style that's really coming in here lately, I've noticed, or over the last year. I have Simplicity 9705. It is a size 14 with a waist of 27, hips of 38, and it is just the skirts for this. That would take a lot of grading, and that is way too short for me, but who knows, maybe my youngest daughter, when she's a little bit older, might want skirts like that. Then we have Simplicity 3065, which is this little sheath dress, really cute. It is a bust 36, so it would be pretty easy for me to go ahead and grade this one up. And as you can see, a lot of these patterns are very, very crispy. Simplicity 4294, which is a coat pattern. It is just for the coat. Well, maybe. No, it's the coat and also the dress. So it is the coat and the dress. So that is a really cute set. Especially when the lining matches your dress. That's actually really cute. Okay, and I have a couple of them that are already packaged up. I don't know who, what, where, when, how, why. But we have Berta 5221. So whoever originally had these actually wanted to protect them. Because it seems very similar to the packaging that I use to protect all of my patterns. So after I get off of here, I will go ahead and start packaging these up to protect everything. We have Berta 4122, which is this outfit here, and it is a size 10 through 20, so a really good size range. And it's both, it looks like it is both the skirt and the top. It looks like it's, yeah, it is separate. So that is really cute. I have another Berta Studio, which is this oversized coat, which this is 4425. Okay, we have a multi-size quick and easy G20758, which is this skirt that looks like back from my childhood again, that a lot of the teachers would wear. And then I have a very easy, very Vogue 9670, which is this dress. And I've got some notes on here for the person that this was being made for. And this was being made back in 86, and she wanted it in navy blue linen. And she had some information written here about the different buttons. And she was using 17 5/8 buttons on this. So that is really cute. And I want to be careful with this one because it is very, very crispy. I'm not able, it is Vogue 3010, and it is some really pretty sheath dresses, but this packaging is so crispy. I am scared about this package, but it does have a couple of different views for the sheath dress, and it is a bust 32. So this one is a little bit too small for me. Uh-oh. Put that back right there. Then we have Vogue Designer Original 2151, and it is this wedding dress with tiered, and you can also have a petticoat, and it also comes with the veil pattern inside of here. It I don't know if it's been used. It's folded nicely, so I can't tell if it had been used. But that is really cute. Size is not on the front. It might be several sizes in one. I don't. No, it's size 8, so. I don't know what size that corresponds with. Oh, size 8, so it's a bust 31 and a half. Trust me, I'll get better about reading stuff, I promise. Then we have Vogue Patterns, American designer Perry Ellis. Pattern 1605. I cannot talk today. And hopefully I did not just hit that really hard and mess everything up. So we have this one. It is a size 12. And a size 12 has a bust of 34. So that would be another item that I would have to grade up quite a bit. And then we have Ann Pearson's Collectibles, the Sedona jacket. And it's a bust 30 through 46, chest 21 through 31. So it looks like it might actually be both the adult and child pattern in this. Ladies, girls, yep, it looks like it is going to be both the mom and daughter jacket. So that is cute. And then another Anna Pearson's Windjammer jacket, which all I can think of is Beck. Oh, these are stretch and sews. Okay. And this is small, medium, and large. I remember wearing a lot of these whenever I was a child. So windjammers and stuff like that, it reminds me of the late 80s, early 90s style, especially for kids. And I think my mom and dad both had matching windbreakers like this. All right, guys, so that is it for today's video. I will be coming back here shortly after I start working on my next project. All right, guys, I'll talk to y'all soon. Bye.